Brayton cycle. The Brayton cycle is the air standard ideal cycle approximation for the gas turbine engine. This cycle differs from the Otto cycle and diesel cycles in that the process making the cycle occur in open systems or control volumes. Therefore, an open system steady flow analysis is used to determine the heat transfer and work for the cycle. We assume the working fluid is air and the specific heats are constant and will consider the cold air standard cycle. The closed cycle gas turbine engine. Closed Brayton cycle. The first, the compressor and two to the heat input to the turbine in to the out. Then thermal efficiency of the Brayton cycle. Brayton is equal to work net over Q in is equal to 1 Q out over minus Q out over Q in. Now to find Q in and Q out, apply the conservation of energy to process 2 and 3 for P is equal to constant torque, steady flow, and neglect changes in kinetic and potential energies. E in is equal to E out. M to H2 plus Q in is equal to M3 H3. The conservation of mass gives M input and M output. M2 is equal to M3 is equal to M. For constant specific heats, the heat added per unit mass flow is Q in is equal to MH3 minus H2. So Q in is equal to MCP T3 minus T2. Then is equal to Qn is equal Qn over M is equal to Cp T3 minus T2. The conservation of energy for process 4 and 1 yields for constant specific heats. Let's take a minute for you to get the following result. So Q out is equal to MH4 minus H1. Q out is equal to MCP T4 minus T1. So Q out is equal to Q out over M is equal to Cp T4 times T4 minus T1. The thermal efficiency becomes Brayton is equal to 1 minus Q out over Q in is equal to 1 minus Q out over Q in. Then is equal to 1 minus Cp times T4 minus T1 over Cp T3 minus T2. Then is equal to 1 minus T4 minus T1 over T3 minus T2. Then 1 is equal to 1 minus T1 times T4 over T1 minus 1 over T2 times T3 over T2 minus 1. Recall process 1, 2, and 3, and 4 are isentropic. So, T1 over T2 is equal to close and open and close parenthesis P2 over V1 of raised to K minus 1 over K. And T3 over T4 is equal to P3 over P4 raised to K minus 1 over K. Since P3 is equal to P2 and P4 is equal to P1, we see that T2 over T1 is equal to T3 over T4 or T4 over T1 is equal to T3 over T2. The Brayton cycle efficiency becomes 1 minus T1 over T2. Is this the same as the Carnot cycle efficiency? Since process 1 and 2 is isentropic, T2 over T1 is equal to close and open parenthesis, pi2 over p1 raised to key minus 1 over key is equal to r p raised to key minus 1 over key. So t1 over t2 is equal to 1 over rp raised to key minus 1 over key, where the pressure ratio is rp is equal to p2 over p1 and Brayton is equal to 1 minus 1 over rp, or pressure ratio key minus 1 over key. So that the diagram of the Brayton, the pressure ratio, typical pressure ratios for gas turbine engines. Regenerative Brayton cycle. For the Brayton cycle, the turbine exhaust temperature is greater than the compressor exit temperature. Therefore, a heat exchanger can be placed between the hot gases leaving the turbine and the cooler gases leaving the compressor. This heat exchanger is called a regenerator or recuperator. The sketch of the regenerative Brayton cycle is shown below. So, regenerative Brayton cycle and this sketch. The compressor, 1, 2, the regenerator, then 3 to the turbine, then back to the regenerator, to the heat input, and the work net is the turbine. So this is the TIS diagram, how work the regeneration. So we define the regenerator effectiveness region as the ratio of the heat transferred to the compressor gases in the regenerator to the maximum possible heat transfer to the compressor gases. So regen act is equal to H5 minus H2. So the regen max is H5 minus H2 is equal to H4 minus H2. So A regen is equal to Q regen act over Q regen max is equal to H5 minus H2, H4 minus H2. So for ideal gases using the cold air standard assumption with constant specific heats, the regenerator effectiveness becomes A regen is equal to T5 minus T2, T4 minus T2. Using the closed cycle analysis and treating the heat addition and heat rejection as steady flow process, the regenerative cycle thermal efficiency is regen is equal to 1 minus Q out over Q in. So is equal to 1 minus H6 minus H1, H3 minus H5. Notice that the heat transfer occurring within the regenerator is not included in the efficiency calculation because this energy is not heat transferred across the cycle boundary. Assuming an ideal regenerator, A regen is equal to 1 and constant specific heats, the thermal efficiency becomes, take the time to show this on your own. So, regen is equal to 1 minus T1 over T3, open parenthesis, P2 over P1, close parenthesis, raised to key minus 1 over key, is equal to 1 minus T1 over T3, open parenthesis, pressure ratio, close parenthesis, raised to key minus 1 over key. When does the efficiency of the air standard Brayton cycle equal the efficiency of air standard regenerative Brayton cycle? If we set nth Brayton is equal to nth regen, the nth Brayton is equal to nth regen, so 1 minus 1 over pressure ratio raised to key minus 1 over key is equal to 1 minus T1 over T3, pressure ratio Q minus 1 over Q. So pressure ratio is equal to T3 over T1 raised to Q over 2 times Q minus 1. Recall that this is the pressure ratio that maximizes the network for the simple Brayton cycle and makes T4 is equal to T2. What happens if the regenerative Brayton cycle operates at a pressure ratio larger than this value? So for fixed T3 and T1, pressure ratios greater than this value cause T4 to be less than T2, and the regenerator is not effective. What happens to the network when a regenerator is added? What happens to the heat supplied when a regenerator is added? So, the following shows a plot of regenerative Brayton cycle efficiency as a function of the pressure ratio and minimum to maximum temperature ratio T1 over T3. So, with regeneration. So, look the diagram. With generation and without regeneration. Next, the cycle schematic is the same as above, and the TS diagram showing the effects of compressor and turbine efficiencies is below. TS diagram for gas turbine with regeneration. This is the TS diagram for gas turbine with generation. Summary of results. The cycle type, the actual, and the ideal. The region, the compressor, the turbine, the Q in, the work compression, work turbine, and work compressor over turbine, and the end. Other ways to improve Brayton cycle performance. This is the other ways that Brayton cycle performance improve. So intercooling and reheating are two important ways to improve the performance of the Brayton cycle with regeneration. First, compressor to intercooler. Then, compressor again. Then going to regenerator, then going to combustion chamber, to the turbine, then reheater, then second turbine, then regenerator again. So we can see that we can observe the diagram how to improve Brayton cycle performance. Next, the TS diagram for this cycle is shown below. So, sketch the PB diagram. So, this is the TS diagram and PB diagram. So, the PB diagram. Then, the intercooling. When using multi-stage compression, cooling the work fluid between the stages will reduce the amount of compressor work required. The compressor work is reduced because cooling the working fluid reduces the average specific volume of the fluid and thus reduces the amount of work on the fluid to achieve the given pressure rise. To determine the intermediate pressure at which intercooling should take place to minimize the compressor work, we follow the approach shown. For the adiabatic steady flow compression process, the work input to the compressor per unit mass is work compression. The integral of VdP is equal to integral VdP plus integral dP plus integral VdP. For the isentropic compression process, Q over Q minus 1 times B2 B2 minus B1 B1 plus key over key minus 1 times B4 B4 minus B3 V3 is equal to key over key minus 1 R times T2 minus T1 plus key R over key minus 1 times T4 minus T3 is equal to key minus over key minus 1 R times T1 times T2 over T1 minus 1 plus T3 times T4 over T3 minus 1. So is equal to key over key minus 1 R T1 times P2 over P1 raised to key minus 1 over key minus 1 plus T3. Open parenthesis P4 plus P3 over P3 raised to key minus 1 over key minus 1 plus parenthesis. Notice that the fraction key R over key minus 1 is equal to constant pressure or CP. So, the compression process is equal to CP then times T2, T1, open parenthesis P2 over P1, plus parenthesis raised to key minus 1 over key minus 1 plus T3, open parenthesis P4 over P3 raised to key minus 1 over key then minus 1. Can you obtain this relation another way and apply the first law to process when and for? For third stage compression, let's assume the intercooling takes place at constant pressure and the gases can be cooled to the inlet temperature for the compressor such that P3 is equals P2 and T3 is equals T1. The total work supplied to the compressor becomes compressor work is equal to CP T1 times close in the open parenthesis P2 over P1 raised to key minus 1 over key minus 1 plus close in open parenthesis P4 over P2 raised to key minus 1 over key minus 1 is equal to CP T1 times P2 over P1 key minus raised to key minus 1 over key plus P4 over P2 raised to key minus 1 over key minus 2. To find the unknown pressure P2 that gives the minimum work input for fixed compressor inlet conditions T1 P1 and exit pressure P4 we set driving work compression times P2 over driving P2 is equal to 0. This yields P2 is equal to square root of P1, P4. So the pressure ratios across the two compressors are equal. P2 over P1 is equal to P4 over P2 is equal to P4 over P3. Intercooling is almost always used with regeneration. During the intercooling, the compressor final exit temperature is reduced. Therefore, more heat must be supplied in the heat addition process to achieve the maximum temperature of the cycle. Regeneration can make a part of the required heat transfer. To supply only compressed air using intercooling requires less working input. The next time you to go home supply store where air compressors are sold, check the larger air compressor to see if intercooling is used. For the larger air compressors, the compressors are made of two piston cylinder chambers. The intercooling heat exchanger is obtained a pipe with attached fins that connects the large piston cylinder chamber with the smaller piston cylinder chamber. Sometimes the flywheel used to drive the compressor has fan type blades as spokes to increase airflow across the compressor and heat exchanger pipe to improve the intercooling effect. Reheating. When using multi-stage expansion through two or more turbines, reheating between stages will increase the network done. It also increases the required heat input. The regenerative Brayton cycle with reheating was shown above. The optimum intermediate pressure for heating is the one that maximizes the turbine work. Following the development given above for intercooling and assuming reheating to the high pressure turbine inlet temperature in a constant pressure steady flow process, we can show the optimum reheat pressure to be. Pressure 7 is equal to square root of pressure 6 and pressure 9. For the pressure ratios across the two turbines are equal. Pressure 6 over pressure 7 is equal to pressure 7 over pressure 9 is equal to pressure 8 over pressure 9. Sample problems. A Brayton cycle with regeneration produces 150 kilowatt power. The rates of heat addition and rejection are to be determined. Assumptions. 1. The air assumptions are applicable. The second is air is an ideal gas with constant specific heats at room temperature. Third, kinetic and potential energy changes are negligible. Properties. The properties of air at room temperature are Cp is equal to 1.005 kilojoule per kilogram Kelvin, and the K is equal to 1.4. Analysis. For the compression and expansion processes, we have T2 is equal to T1, pressure ratio raised to K minus 1 over K is equal to 293 Kelvin times 8 raised to 0.4 times 1.4 is equal to 530.8 Kelvin. Then, the ninth compressor, Cp over T2 minus T1, Cp over T2 minus T1 is equal to T2 is equal to T1 plus T2 minus T1, the compression. And thank you.